afternoon class today, as well as the rest of the week, will be in the lab here instead of the classroom. Now, what are we doing in the lab? You may wonder. This week, we are going to be performing some experiments. Experiments lined up for us today. The first experiment will involve baking soda. Now, you may say, well, this is something that we in the house. This is true. But this still is a chemical agent. But we're also going to see what reaction baking soda has with another chemical that you may have in your household. And that is vinegar. Now, can anybody tell me what they think reaction will be with baking soda and vinegar? Does anybody have any ideas or any guesses as to what will happen? Yes. Okay. How about you? See if any of you are correct. Very good guesses, though. Very good guesses. So, our second experiment that we're going to do today is going to be with baking soda tartaric acid and water. So we're going to have two very interesting experiments today. Baking soda. This interesting combination. What does everyone think is going to happen? Will it change color? Will it bubble or boil? Or will it turn into a volcano? What's your guess? Okay. It's you. Interesting. How about you? Okay. Well, let's get ready. Begin and see what happens with these chemicals. You'll find everything you need at your lab stations, including the chemicals, the tools, as well as PPE equipment, lab coat, gloves, goggles. Let's all get our PPE on, and then we'll begin. And while you all get ready, I'm going to get everything set up and get ready as well. Now that we're all ready, all you're going to do is follow my instruction and pretty much do what I do. Alright? Okay, so we pair of scissors. A spoon. A pivot. The baking soda. The vinegar. As well as our stations, which includes test tubes and beakers. So, first step, PPE. Let's move this solid to the side for a minute. Alright, so the first thing you're going to do is take your bag of baking soda and your scissors. To take 1 spoonful of baking soda, and we're going to place that into the test tube. So you're just going to get a nice little amount, just enough that it fills the spoon. Carefully and gently, we're going to pour it in to the test tube. Now, warning, it will get all over the place. That's okay. Cap back on and put it in our station. Next, we are going to take the vinegar. We're going to open up the vinegar. Some of the vinegar. You might want to close that back up. There we go. you're going to slowly drop a few drops of the vinegar into the test tube. And this will produce a carbon dioxide gas. And watch what happens. See how it bubbles. It's a pretty neat chemical reaction, right? Go ahead and add a few more drops. The more you add, the more it fizzes and bubbles, like so. This reaction kind of reminds you of an Alka-Seltzer or Pop Rocks. Now, how many of you guessed that it would fizz and bubble like that? Somehow I doubt that you all do. The next experiment. So just place that in your station, but keep the lid on. It's pressurized now. So now we're going to move on to the next experiment. This should be pretty interesting. So, if you will, grab your water, keep your baking soda, and grab the tartaric acid. And grab yourself a new pipette. And then we shall begin. Take your bag of tartaric acid. Just give it a couple smacks. And take your scissors. And again, just cut the top off a little bit. Not to cut much off. Then dispose of the garbage. Now, we're going to grab a new test tube. Take the lid off. Set it to the side. Spoonful of the baking soda, as well as one spoonful of the tartaric acid, and then we're going to place it in the test tube. milliliters of water to the testing. So that will be labeled right on your pip. 2 milliliters. So unscrew your bottle of water. Scissors on that. Now, let's add the water and see what happens. What's everyone think? Let's just see what happens. And that's what happens. I'm sure none of you guessed phones. So, as you can tell, it phoned. Kudos to all of you who guessed that it phoned. And yes, it does smell like rotten eggs. So, now you can see what we're in for the rest of the week. Some really fun experiments, but very interesting and educational. All right, class, let's clean up our lab stations, and then you can wait until the bell rings.